Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Baba Salam, and I welcome you to a new episode in the second season of the Dua series, brought to you by Al-Bushra by GSalam. Today's Dua comes from page number 114 in Getting Closer to Him by the Day, 101 Duas You Can't Go Without. If you have your copy of the book, you can refer to page number 114. If you don't have a copy of the book, it is fine. You can follow with us by going to gsalam.net/dua, and you'll find this particular dua inside there, inshallah. Together, you will also be able to download the poster of the dua to make use of it and share with your kids as well as with your loved ones. This dua comes from Surah Al-Qasas, verse number 28, and it relates part of what Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam went through. And in one instance, he happened to have to separate between two fighting parties. And he accidentally hit one party, and then the man died. Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam's first reaction was to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he did that, he said one line of dua, which was registered in the Quran forever. And here we are going to learn it. It is easy, it is simple, and you will be surprised by how you are going to memorize it in three attempts if you have not memorized it yet. The dua says, Rabbi inni zalamtu nafsi faghfirli. Let's repeat. Rabbi inni zalamtu nafsi faghfirli. Let's repeat again. Rabbi inni zalamtu nafsi faghfirli. Let's link it together. Rabbi inni zalamtu nafsi faghfirli. It means, my Lord, indeed I have wronged myself, so forgive me. Now, this dua is used to seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, regardless of what sin you have committed. Of course, unless hudud is involved, even when hudud is involved, this dua is perfectly relevant to any human being, more so the believer who wrongs himself at any point of time. Once wrongdoing doesn't have to be a major one, like what happened in Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam's case, where a life is lost before he says, Rabbi inni zalamtu nafsi faghfirli. Once wrongdoing can be hurting a fellow brethren without intention. Where and when someone's right is involved, you will have to ensure that you give back the rights and then seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this dua, we can make use of it at any time. Rabbi inni zalamtu nafsi faghfirli. My Lord, indeed I have wronged myself, so forgive me. Teach the kids and share it with your loved ones. And whether intentionally or unintentionally, we all sin. But at the end of the day, the only one who forgives sins is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is only Him to whom we should return whenever we commit sin, we wrong ourselves, or even whenever we are not sure if we have done something wrong. Rabbi inni zalamtu nafsi faghfirli. Rabbi inni zalamtu nafsi faghfirli. And you will definitely be able to see the impact when one repeats it at all times or frequently. Because you don't need to have a book in order to remember this dua. That is one thing. The other thing is you can make it as part of your dhikr. Just imagine you dedicate one day keeping repeating this, or an hour in a day, or a certain time in a day repeating this dua. Because it is simple, because it is easy. Rabbi inni zalamtu nafsi faghfirli. Rabbi inni zalamtu nafsi faghfirli. In the event you want to include it among other du'as you are going to read in a congregation among jama'ah, then you may want to put it in a plural form, which comes like Rabbana innana zalamna anfusana faghfir lana. With that, we have come to the end of this episode of Dua. If you are watching this on YouTube, please do me a favor and do the channel a favor. Consider subscribing so that we will grow. And for them, that is the way the message will be able to reach bigger audience as possible. If you are watching this on Facebook, please consider following the page and sharing it with your newsfeed as well as with your loved ones. If you have received this through your WhatsApp inbox, please consider forwarding it to anyone whom you believe it will benefit, inshallah. Until we meet in the next, I leave you in Allah's protection. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Ya Allah, Ya Allah.